subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Monday, the 1st of November. Indian Prime Minister Modi attends COP26 Climate Summit in Glasgow. Displaced Afghan women in Kabul plea for help, says cold weather killed their newborns. And lawyers stage protest for second day demanding resignation of Chief Justice of Nepal. And now for all the details, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi attended the 26th session of the Conference of Parties or COP26 Climate Change Summit a day after wrapping up his Rome visit, where he attended the G20 summit. British Prime Minister Boris Johnson opened the conference, saying the world is trapped to a doomsday device and warned of uncontainable public anger if COP26 fails.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi was welcomed by his British counterpart Boris Johnson and UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres as he arrived along with other world leaders to attend the United Nations 26th Conference of Parties or COP26 Climate Change Summit being held in Glasgow in the United Kingdom. The British Prime Minister opened the summit saying the world is trapped to a doomsday device and warned of uncontainable public anger if COP26 fails. The global conference comes a day after the G20 economies failed to commit to a 2050 target to halt net carbon emissions, a deadline widely cited as necessary to prevent the most extreme global warming. India is the world's third biggest emitter of greenhouse gases after China and the United States. And Modi's participation to present India's climate action agenda in the conference, which will run till November 12, was seen as critical. PM Modi was also scheduled to hold separate bilateral meetings on the sidelines of COP26, which came a day after he wrapped up his three-day visit to Italy, where he attended the G20 summit in Rome and interacted with various world leaders, and also invited Pope Francis to India.
And after being shut for more than 19 months, schools in Indian capital New Delhi finally reopened on Monday for all classes with 50% capacity after the COVID-19 pandemic became less severe. Delhi recorded just 4 COVID-19 related deaths in October, the lowest monthly toll since the first fatality from the pandemic in March last year. Schools also opened the doors to students in Southern Kerala and Tamil Nadu states.
Students returned to schools in the Indian capital New Delhi and Southern Kerala state on Monday as educational institutions reopened months after the coronavirus shutdown. Students were seen actively participating in the sports activities inside the campus of a New Delhi school on Monday. India in March last year had ordered the closure of schools, colleges and other educational institutions and pushed for classes to move online to curb the spread of the deadly virus. Students wore masks, sanitized their hands and got their temperatures checked as they arrived for offline classes. New Delhi reported 348 active cases as of Monday, while Kerala reported 79,795 active cases, the maximum in the country.
I feel excited to finally come out from a bubble. And we haven't been into the outside for a long while, and now we are coming back to our safe zone, and I feel really excited to come back here.
India on Monday reported 12,514 new COVID-19 infections, taking the active cases to 158,817. Cases in the country have been dipping since a peak hit in April, but health experts fear a possible spike during the ongoing festival season, as people have been thronging markets and often seen flouting social distancing norms.
Moving on, London-based Kashmiri political activist Dr. Shabir Chaudhary in a recent interview busted several myths concerning the history of India's Jammu and Kashmir presented by Pakistan. Chaudhary said the present cause of the ongoing issue in the region is all linked with the tribal invasion of October 22, 1947, which was backed by the Pakistani army.
Busting several myths concerning the history of India's Jammu and Kashmir presented by Pakistan, London-based Kashmiri political activist Dr. Shabir Chaudhary recently linked all problems of the region to the tribal invasion of October 22, 1947, backed by the Pakistani army. In an interview on the social media, Chaudhary highlighted horrifying stories of mass plunder, killings and vandalism when nearly 10,000 tribesmen backed by Pakistan army invaded Kashmir in October 1947 to occupy it by force. The invasion also resulted in nearly a third of the territory, now known as Pakistan-administered Kashmir, falling to the raiders. Chaudhary said it was unprovoked and unilateral violation of the Standstill Agreement reached by Pakistan.
जम्मू कश्मीर के डिवाइडेड जम्मू कश्मीर के वो मुसलमान जो अब भी पाकिस्तान के प्रोपेगेंडे के ज़ेर असर हैं उनको ये पता होना चाहिए कि उनका उनके अपने मकासद है जम्मू कश्मीर पर हमला करने के और वेलफेयर ऑफ द पीपल या उनकी वेलफेयर या उनकी हिफाजत कोई उनके मसला नहीं था इट वाज नॉट देयर प्रायोरिटी प्रायोरिटी वाज टू प्रोटेक्ट उनकी जो अपनी मिलिट्री स्ट्रेटेजिक एंड रिसोर्सेज था.
Chaudhary also raised concern over Pakistan's attempts to change demography of Pakistan-administered Kashmir over the years through so-called developmental projects. October 22nd is also marked as a Black Day by people in illegally occupied region who have long blamed their denied basic fundamental rights and are meted out with severe brutality for voicing their concerns.
And as winter sets in, many Afghans displaced in recent fighting have yet to receive aid. A group of women near capital Kabul said the cold, dire conditions have claimed the lives of several newborn babies. Calling for help and assistance, displaced Afghan families say newborn babies are dying because of the winter cold.
Displaced Afghan families in capital Kabul on Sunday called for help on their dire situation and claimed that newborn babies have died of coldness in recent days. The chilly weather underlined the urgency in getting assistance to thousands of displaced people, many having fled from the provinces and are sleeping in tents or improvised accommodation around the city.
اینجا اشته کوی بعض اشته کوی که است چهار پنج تا طفل اینجا پیدا شد بعض شای خونی که را مرد یک تو این دل روز یک می سفید ده اینجا موتر زد پوش می ده شد یک طفل ده سر سرک برام داد مشکلاتی را که یک رپ نون پیدا کنه ده دست شده موتر را درست کنه او از چکت موتر زد بیچاره مرد ده این رقم مشکلات بسیار زیاد قرار داریم.
Humanitarian assistance began to trickle into Afghanistan following warnings the country faces potentially catastrophic famine this winter, but none of the aid has reached this group of displaced people. UNHCR, United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees, had previously calculated about 50,000 Afghans from different provinces were displaced because of recent conflicts and have moved to Kabul. Even before the Taliban's victory over the Western-backed government in Kabul 2 months ago, more than 18 million Afghans, or about half the population, needed humanitarian aid, according to the UNHCR. The Afghan people are suffering from growing inadequacy of food and clothing, as grain prices have kept soaring due to the freezing of Afghanistan's bank assets by the United States. The Taliban on Saturday called on Washington and other capitals to recognize their government in Afghanistan, warning that a failure to do so and the continued freezing of Afghan funds abroad would lead to problems not only for the country but for the world. No country has formally recognized the Taliban government since the insurgents took over the country in August, while billions of Afghan assets and funds abroad have also been frozen, even as the country faces severe economic and humanitarian crisis.
And moving on to news from Nepal, judges of the Nepal Supreme Court and lawyers associated with the Nepal Bar Association on Monday staged a protest for the second day inside the premises of the court, demanding the resignation of Chief Justice Chulendra Shamsher Rana from his post. Rana has been accused of seeking to appoint his brother-in-law as a minister in Prime Minister Sher Bahadur Deoba's cabinet and delaying the hearing of cases filed against appointments to the constitutional bodies. The lawyers have warned of intensifying their protest further if the Chief Justice does not resign by 2nd of November. Earlier, the justices and advocates in the Supreme Court had boycotted the hearing session and benches allotted by C.J. Rana, blaming him for making attempts to take political and personal incentives while delivering verdicts. Chief Justice Rana had clarified that he will not resign from his post under pressure, but will vacate his post through the constitutional process of impeachment. The lawyers and advocates who have come down against the Chief Justice for the first time in Nepali legal history claim that the latest round of agitation would ward off ill practices that remain in the judicial system. And to ensure effective response by all stakeholders in case of emergency or disaster, local administration in collaboration with National Disaster Response Force conducted mock drills recently in Tawang district of India's northeastern Arunachal Pradesh state near Chinese border. The drills saw participation from Buddhist monks of Tawang Monastery who were trained for an earthquake-like scenario.
Buddhist monks in Tawang district of India's northern Arunachal Pradesh state near Chinese border trained with NDRF, National Disaster Response Force, to ensure effective response by all stakeholders in case of emergency. The mock drills were conducted to analyze and enhance the level of preparedness in the event of a disaster with up to 7.2 magnitude of earthquake. Located at 3,048 meters above the sea level, Tawang of Arunachal Pradesh falls under Zone 5 and is prone to earthquakes, landslides and other such natural calamities.
जैसा कि कल हमने टेबल टॉप एक्सरसाइज किया था कि 7.2 रिक्टर स्केल पे मैग्नीट्यूड का अर्थक्वेक तवांग में आया है उस और उसके बेसिस पे हमने एक सिनेरियो बनाया था तो आज उसी सिनेरियो पे हमने एक्चुअल मॉक ड्रिल किया है तो ये मॉक ड्रिल का जो साइट था एक्चुअल साइट था वो तवांग मोनेस्ट्री है.
Monks were trained to rescue victims from a collapsed house due to the earthquake and rescue from a high building in case of fire or other emergency. The event was conducted with the joint efforts of the Indian Army, paramilitary forces and the stakeholders from different departments like medical, fire, veterinary and others.
And potters in parts of India have said their business is coming back on track as the demand of traditional earthen lamps has increased ahead of Diwali, the festival of lights. Markets are also abuzz with activity as people are rushing for festive shopping.
After being marred by coronavirus pandemic for 2 years, potters in India's Gorakhpur city say the business is coming back on track as the demand for traditional earthen lamps is increasing with Diwali, the festival of lights just around the corner. The clay products traditionally associated with the festivities include different kinds of designer, non-designer, colourful, plain, big and small earthen lamps along with clay toys and decorative items as well. As part of tradition, Goddess Lakshmi and Lord Ganesha are worshipped with only earthen lamps. Diwali will be celebrated on November 4 this year.
दिया का सीजन इस समय तो बहुत तेजी पे है. मान लीजिए इस समय दिया जो है त्योहार का मौसम है. हर चीज बनता है, कोसा है, दिया है, बच्चों का खिलौना है, भोपा भी बना बचाने वाला भी है, वो भी बनता है. ते हम लोग थोक में बेच देते हैं.
Meanwhile, people across the country are thronging markets in large numbers for festive shopping. Diwali marks the return of Hindu Lord Ram to the city of Ayodhya after he defeated Ravan, the powerful demon king of Lanka. People decorate their homes with oil and electric lamps to mark the occasion and also celebrate by bursting firecrackers.
So primarily the reason to coming to Chandni Chowk is to, you know, explore the variety of home decor and the lights which we get. We used to, you know, decorate our household.
Diwali is also celebrated in honor of Lakshmi, the Hindu goddess of wealth and prosperity. It is believed that Lakshmi, signifying prosperity, comes into those homes that are clean and well lit.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.